Hey guys, it's Rick Rivers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Atletico Madrid career mode, where last time I left off. I continued on my good start to this new career mode. Things are going well. Oh, 3 league games, 3 wins, 1 Champions League game, 1 Champions League game. I mean, you can't ask for a much better start than that, can you?
Well, the vibrant football that comes from La Liga is on offer for
back
you
home
today. To describe it, I've got Alan Smith alongside myself, Martin
game
Tyler. Alan
against Sporting
is, football where it's at, I guess.
Yeah,
Dion.
Martin, looking forward to it.
I know it's probably, I think it's pronounced Gijon or
today, Atletico like Madrid against Sporting
Gijon. I'm going, I hear the,
Andre Morera is the goalkeeper. Thiago plays with Gabby and the
people who
the
work for Sky Sports.
Guerrero starts. He was man of the match last time out.
That's Gijon.
Atletico Madrid. Interesting.
To be honest, I always call it Sporting Gijon because their name reminds me of the, you know, those chicken things. So, yeah. You probably didn't notice that I'm using a secondary team. The reason I'm doing that is because I have a game 2 days after this because, you know, fuck logic. Fuck having, you know, time to prepare for different opponents. Fuck having,
and that has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Logical gaps between games. Now, I mean, 2 days after this. And it's not any small team. If you didn't see the last episode, it's Barcelona. Yeah. So, yeah, I'm playing my second team again here on Gijon. Because, honestly, I need my best players full stamina. They need to be fully alert, ready to go. Hope for that game against Barcelona.
Today because the home side have won their last 3 matches.
Well, full of confidence, and with the home crowd behind them, I think it'll be tough for the visitors.
Tackle goes in.
Because Barcelona's one-game blip was indeed just that, a one-game blip, because they've won all 3 of their other games.
Well, they've taken
so far in the league and are 1 point above me. Friends, they have played 4 games, and I'm currently in the midst of playing my 4th game, but still.
Well, he's doubled up here with his second goal, and
I can't
took it in excellent slack. Start, just like the first one.
And take my foot off the gas when it comes to.
Vieto.
Playing a top team.
Attacking
I need
dangerous.
To have my best team forward and available.
Kevin Guerrero! And Atletico Madrid get given a corner here. Jimenez!
You'll notice some differences in the team as well from the last time you guys saw him play. Rechanged around the central midfield with Gabby E. Fernandez.
Well, the clock is
and Thiago all coming in.
For traditionalists and particularly the Atletico Madrid supporters, and it'll be a sad day when it goes, but it is in the name.
Jimenez is playing at centre back.
Can stand still. We've seen that across Europe and the world, and I think the new place is going to hold about 73,000. So it's a
yeah. I recalled Vieto from back from loan to, well, give me a striking option to partner with Kevin Guerrero, because as I stated in the last episode, Nunez, or whatever the fuck his name is. He is the poor man's Fernando Torres. And I am not putting up with a poor man's Fernando Torres. I alone not of the real thing. If I wanted Torres, I would have just kept his dumb ass around.
I think attacking players favour Alan, don't they?
I think they do, yeah, because it means mistakes from defenders. And, you know, a little bit of miscommunication.
No, I don't give a shit what happened to him in real life. I don't care.
Trying to find a way through here. Probing away. And that's broken up by the defender before the cross could come in.
So, yeah, I recall Vieta.
Here's a chance to attack. Oh.
It was a tough choice between him and Jota.
And shoots!
Huh?
He's blocked the shot well.
But, in the end, I went with Vieto because he's a bit higher rated.
So the referee awards a free kick.
And slightly older than Jota, so I felt Jota would benefit more from being out alone for the season.
There's real threat from
rather than being recalled after only a few games.
Deflected behind, a clear corner.
Now maybe I'll, I don't know, I was thinking maybe
no
having a,
focusing on this fella.
Signing a player in when January comes around and reloading out Vieto. I think it'll come down to how Vieto does between now and January, whenever his opportunities arise.
Saw it coming, cut it out, good work.
Of course he'll get game time in the
whip it in. Comes out with a punch to
Champions League, but of course,
saved by the goalkeeper.
The Copa del Rey is still yet to begin. At least for me, anyway. Corner might be my last chance to make it 3-0 before halftime, and I don't think that's gonna happen because this keeper's probably gonna. Oh, no, wait. It pretty much was the last kick of the game.
2-0.
Team's first half domination. Just look at that. 9 shots, 8 of them on target. Yeah, I'm only 2-0 up.
Now they're behind. They've got
crazy.
To try and
crazy.
Switch things around. And here comes a substitution. Could be dangerous. That's a good spot by the defender.
Thiago.
Romero stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. We've got the away manager indicating he wants to make a substitution now. Well, good through ball.
Avanes, yes, 3-0, and it's his first goal for the club. Moment for him.
But Atletico Madrid, big success this, and by a pretty decent margin it looks like.
Yeah, I don't think they would have fancied this at the start of the match.
Pitch perfect pass.
Very well taken.
As Verdo scores, as I said, his first goal in an Atletico Madrid shirt. In fact, in any shirt, because I'm his first club.
He's done that. There's good progress with this attack. That attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance. Wonderful chance. Oh, well saved. Well, the corner count rises and rises.
That shot was Vieto's first of the game, I'm pretty sure.
Thinking for the away side, time for a change.
Not sure what to make of that. He's been
if you look at the coaching manual,
pretty
don't defend like that. He's got
anonymous throughout this game. Yeah.
A chance for Atletico Madrid.
Vieto. There we go. Now he's done something of significance. He's assisted the Gromit for a hat-trick goal, which makes it 4-0. I'm going back to the top of La Liga.
We'll be signing the match ball for him afterwards.
And yeah.
Yeah, he won't forget this day in a hurry. Top stuff from him.
Turning out to be a comfortable game, this 4-0.
Kevin's only issue now, always, unfortunately.
The La Liga fixture.
He has two strikers on top four. I'm ahead of him.
In the past,
which puts him in the same.
Got in the way. In comes the challenge.
Boat as well. 20 minutes. I don't know if Daniel Sturridge's form might have died out in my Liverpool for a mode.
For the away team.
Boat.
Play on, says the referee.
I guess you guys can decide on that in the next few Liverpool Kerbo videos, which will be up
and the manager
Monday and Wednesday. This will be, of course, Saturday's video. That was, I'll be recording
Kevin Gamero. And he's got the ball away from him with the tackle.
For the week. As well as
what about Heon's next game?
Sunday's video. Well, don't need to record today, but I can.
I think it'll be a tough one for them.
Atletico Madrid now attacking dangerously, and the cross is in. Cross on. Oh, there's a collector's item.
I sure waited for that to come in that home.
The defenders there can't believe it. Neither can his teammates actually.
Counting down towards the end of the 90 minutes. 9 minutes left. This has been called a football match, but it hasn't been much of a match-up between the two sides. The winners conclusively at their best, and the losers just aching to hear the final whistle now. We could do a better cross than that, I think, and it was easy to cope with. And here comes the counter-attack.
Alvaro,
good finish, no doubt, Martin.
It's his second goal of the game.
What about the passing? Wonderful team effort.
And then good
competition
for
goalkeeping in this team, and I think he might just be going down
reasons.
The pecking order after this.
Well, we know the life of a keeper. You make a mistake, and invariably it comes back to haunt you, and that was a big mistake.
5-0, and the game underway again. Sometimes being favourite in a match can weigh heavily, expectation and all that. It's not a problem for this team, is it?
No, I think their manager will be delighted because they've not taken it easily at all. They've given respect to their opponents, but they've shown their class too.
Success here is the whistle.
We've lived up.
Hey! The yellow card, it didn't even matter because the referee's like, yeah, time to end the game.
La Liga. Atletico Madrid 5, Real Sporting Gijón 0. Let's see what that means for the league tables. At the top of the table, we have new leaders in Atletico Madrid with 12 points. In second, Barcelona with 10 points. In third, Villarreal with 10 points. In fourth, Eibar with 10 points. In fifth, Real Sociedad with 9 points. In sixth, Valencia with 8 points. In seventh, Malaga with 7 points.
E7,
Celta Vigo with 5 points. And then, really,
don't need
the table,
a goalkeeper
second
anyway.
Bottom, Real Betis with 2 points. Third bottom, Deportivo Alavés with 3 points. Fourth bottom, Las Palmas with 3 points. Fifth bottom, Sevilla with 3 points.
I'll keep an eye on him. What's his 275? Guy looks like I think that 93 guy would have just his rating would have probably dropped, his potential rating, that is, would have just continued to drop as the months went on. Anyway, he off a wiggle to a stadium I've been to in real life. For those of you who are new to the channel, not this stadium that you see here in the arena thing post game. I mean the Barcelona stadium, the Camp Nou or the Nou Camp, whatever you want to call it.
Well, here we are, Alan Smith and myself, Martin Tyler, really what? Looking forward to
El Liberty Torridor.
Barcelona, they play Atletico Madrid.
Is it not Nou Camp anymore? Hello? Head to head, the Barcelona Arena Stadium. This one could be a cracker.
Great defensive organization for Atletico Madrid.
Okay, I'm massive. Will have to produce
something special to break through this defense.
It's almost an old-fashioned way about Atletico Madrid's play. They're hard to break down, they hit on the break. Very organized, they're very impressive.
I'll talk about a team totaling more than...
This could be it.
Oh, straight away. What a start. Get in, Antoine.
And he's found the back of the net again.
What a start.
Just look at the way he's got past these defenders, Alan, and really maximised the situation he created for himself.
Well, he did. He was head down and some wonderful balance and footwork to beat a couple of defenders and knock the ball in the back of the net. Wonderful goal.
And 2 minutes in, and Antoine Griezmann opens the scoring.
Samuel Umtiti.
Like a mother trucking boss.
Griezmann. On to the attack now.
Peace. That's one thing Barcelona's defense is not really equipped to deal with, is pace. Saying that, they are not hostages themselves when it comes to offensive pace.
Sense that we get with Atletico
Madrid. I mean, when you have Neymar, Messi, and Suarez up front, people are going to have a hard time dealing with you, especially if they struggle against pace. If you're a team that struggles against pace, just don't bother playing Barcelona. Just, you know, if you have to play them, go up to them before the game and say, hey, you know what, let's just say, you a lot of time, you know, you guys can just have the win, because, you know, we're not going to win this match anyway, so why?
Lionel Messi. Oh. Another turnover in play here with that interception. The break is...
Why play to an inevitable conclusion? Because, I mean, if you struggle against pace, Barcelona will rip you apart.
Miranda. Nicolas Gaitán. Good position. They've worked this attack very well into a quite a dangerous position now. And now the shot. Well, he's tried for his second goal of the game. Keeper's got the better of him this time.
Well, you thought there was only one winner there, but in the end, it was the keeper that came forward and did the business.
Sergi Roberto. Well, you just wonder with Atletico Madrid whether the bigger the occasion, the sterner their resolve. They're that kind of team, aren't they? And it's a big occasion playing Barcelona here.
It's the kind of club that no player would look forward to facing, and that's a huge...
Real opening now!
Correa. And trying to lift it into Griezmann. Correa.
Timely challenge.
Ah, screw you, Gomez. Screw you.
Interesting to see what footwear the teams are going to actually use today, now that this rain is coming down. Might have to change what they originally started with.
Yeah, and I think sometimes with the lads wearing blades these days, you do see...
Well, hey, Suarez over here, and Messi didn't get
to change them halfway through this match.
Felipe Luis. Miranda.
Miranda. Anderson. Go on. Yes.
Well, they're in a good position here. And in goes the cross.
Ben. Sergio Roberto, you...
That'll go down as a poor cross, really.
Building asshole. Here,
keeping possession. There's the ball in. They cope with
the nine Frenchmen. And again. You must have some beef with French people.
Got the tackle in. Koke! The goalkeeper plunged to make the save. That's a corner for Atletico Madrid. And the cross coming in. And in comes the header.
Wonderful. Oh, the cross, the great header, but a fantastic save from this lesson.
And he goes for goal with it.
Correa!
That is a terrific header. Unlucky, it's just off target.
They generated some power on it, and the keeper wasn't getting there.
Sergi Roberto. Well, that's half time at 1-0.
Actually, I want to make a change at time.
There's been plenty of warming up going on, and now I think one of the substitutes will be brought into the game.
I completely forgot. Luckily, I stopped working before they kicked off.
Comes in strongly. Okay. It's looking good, this move. And that ball belongs to the goal. He wants to play on the shoulder of the last defender. He's just got to get it right.
I don't know why you're reacting. I'm so surprised. I mean, a blind man could have told you you were offside.
Makes a challenge here.
So, you know, pay attention next time, you know?
Good through pass. Sergio Busquets. Neymar. Strong challenge. Angel Correa. He's coming forward with some danger. And here comes the counter-attack.
Griezmann. 2-0. There we go.
They lead by two now. They'll feel a little bit more comfortable, and they're good value.
And that classic Antoine Griezmann, that celebration.
Well, scoring in any game is worthy of celebration. When you get two, it is special, and he is feeling that special delight at the moment. Another angle on it here.
Go with it. Wonderful. 8 goals already.
2-0. Well, we're two-thirds of the way through the 90 minutes. Half an hour to go. Attacking well here.
From 5 games, that's a 8% average.
Griezmann.
And
here's the shot. That's a good save. He got a touch to that. Atletico Madrid have a corner.
Ooh! Imagine if that had gone in.
Behind for the corner for Atletico Madrid.
I mean, it was dipping. However, how we go?
Godin! Great work by the goalkeeper. The ball is his and he's made sure he's protected it. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. And Barcelona on the attack. Barcelona want to do something, need to do something now.
Well, those defenders are going to be asked to head the ball quite a lot, I think. Plenty of aerial balls are going to be coming their way in the next few moments.
Griezmann. Oh, he's through.
Correa gets a Griezmann for the hat-trick. And the hat-trick is complete.
And it's a perfect day for the block.
Gets in.
Well, a wonderful achievement to get 3 goals in a team like this, against opposition like this. It's a special day.
Certainly is, for a special player too. A player that is the clinical sort, and he's shown us that today.
Well, they've widened the margin now. 3-0 they lead. And it is a Barcelona substitution we're about to see. That's a turnover of possession here. The break is definitely on. He's got his shot off now. Oh, saved by the goalkeeper.
Correa trying to add to the scoreline, but no luck. One with that header.
Atletico Madrid winning possession. Defender to it first.
Ah, damn it, PK. Get your Shakira fucking ass out of my way. Hey, next time.
He's got to do better, otherwise what's the point in having him out there?
Well, here could be a chance for the corner. That's interesting, the corner. Miranda! And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. Got on the ball in midfield, well read by the player in that part of the pitch. Mesut Ozil. Lionel Messi comes in strongly. Yannick Carrasco moving. Oh, he could be in. And shoots.
Carrasco.
He's kept it out.
Not win that header.
He's coming forward with some danger. That's the final whistle.
The shot was a little too high, but in the end it didn't matter. 3-0 is the final score. All 3 goals coming from Antoine Griezmann, giving me a nice gap to Barcelona. And Real Madrid have lost. Nil.
Espanyol 2. Barcelona 0.
I'm going to have to check this to be sure, but I don't think Real Madrid, I don't think Real Madrid have won a game yet.
Sevilla 2.
Not like Real Madrid have won a game.
So what do those results mean to the league table?
Real Madrid.
At the top of the table remain Atletico Madrid with 15 points.
They might have.
In second,
nope,
Villarreal
they have.
With 13 points.
From five games, Real Madrid have three draws and two losses.
In fifth, Eibar with 10 points.
You may as well say they're already out of the title race. You can't drop that many points in this league this early and get away with it.
And then reading up the table, second bottom, Real Betis.
Terrific start.
Third bottom, Deportivo Alves with 3 points.
Real Madrid.
Fourth bottom, Las Palmas with 3 points.
Barcelona recovered from their split
with 3 points.
And before I beat them, we're on a 3-game winning streak. Real Madrid are on a 5-game streak without wins. This is very un-Real Madrid. I don't know what else to say. I mean, I can't really add anything to this because I have legit no idea what the hell is going on. Real Madrid fans aren't too pleased with it. Anyway, next episode I'll have my second group stage game. Game in the Champions League when I play PSV. And, yeah, other than that, it'll be, game to keep an eye on. Until next episode, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. Smash the like button if you did. Subscribe if you're new. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.